Hey. Hey guys and gals, here we are. We're getting ready to head out up to Tonopah. Got the dogs are all in the truck. They're all ready to go. The RV all hooked up. Gassed up, tires all aired up. So we're getting ready to go. So had to stop and get some air. Our generator didn't have enough juice to fire up the air compressor, so got a couple of low tires we got to get. So we're all locked up. We're all locked up and heading north. Stay tuned. We'll be coming to you on and off on the whole trip. All right. God bless, guys. See you in a bit. Hey, everybody. We are in Beatty, Nevada. 1 hour and 15 minutes into a 7 hour drive. Just think, in 6 more hours we'll be there. The dogs are primed up. Everybody's all primed up, but this is Beatty, Nevada. Get camera lady to show you around a bit. It's an old mining town. Got a lot of old buildings. Smoking Jay's Barbecue.
This must be a good place to eat.
Eatery and saloon. Ooh, our little Eddie Murphy. My girl wants to party all the time.
They sell a bunch of military supplies there.
Ammo cans.
There's the RV park.
The El Suno, or Suno, I don't know, whatever that hotel
thing is.
We got a happy car wash.
And this is where my favorite candy store is. Somewhere up here. They sell all kinds of this right here. They sell all kinds of candy. Anything you think of.
Stagecoach, it's Eddie's World. Stagecoach Hotel and Casino.
Well, that was a big town. I'll get back to you. That was it.
There's a guy like, out here with Norbert Anyways. There's a guy like, in Darkvision. Darkvision. Look at that. Good size. Around here, nobody says yes. Straight up behind us.
Alright, here we go again. We're still outside of Beatty. We're closing in on Goldfield. Well, there we go. It just got lighter in here. I had to change hats. My other hat was too hot. 83 degrees still. So, and that's a winter hat. So, alright, we'll get back in a little bit. Weird lady. Well, that was fun. We just blew a tire and we didn't grab the camera. Thank God for impact wrenches. It was like a NASCAR tire change. So, I'm going to give you the land.
Yeah, we should have excused the hair. I've been packing everything. Yeah, we'll show you the tire when we stop next time. We got to get it repaired, get a new tire put on it. It's shredded. All right, we'll get back to you.
Well, if you're ever out in the middle of nowhere and you're a single guy, there, right there, is the Shady Lady Brothel Bed and Breakfast. A lot of ee-oo going on there. I don't know how they're doing it with social distancing, but yeah, we just went through a construction zone right after we blowed the tire. Boom! So we're heading down the highway again. We're working on getting to Goldfield, Nevada.
I thought you said Tonopah.
gold fields.
Yeah, see over there, I don't know if you can see it with my phone, but they rerouted the highway around because they found gold. Like, look, kind of looking like over where that truck is. So they had the gold mining company paid for the reroute so they could get into the gold over here. I'm thinking it's over where all that equipment is. They're just stocking in there, but from what I understand, what I heard, that they found gold, so the gold company rerouted the highway around where they found it. So that's a pretty cool little history. Pretty nice little highway through here. Well, there's one for all you single guys. Looks like Barbara Bell. You guys don't know who Barbara Bell is anyway. So there's some more mines over there. So check out the donkeys. Wild donkeys.
Bunch of asses.
A whole bunch of asses standing out in the field there. What an ass field that is. Check out the cattle ranch. You guys got a whole bunch of cows. Check out that mountain range right there. I don't know if you can see it very good, but that is really cool. Look at all the ranches.
I'm all greasy and you're filming me.
What you making?
A snack of dinner chewing.
Look at that. Summer sausage, cheese, and crackers. That's classic hunting food right there. Yeah. All right, we'll get back to you in a little bit. I got a munch.
See if I can zoom in once rolling over there.
Yeah, they're wallering.
They're all laying up into the... They protect the donkeys here, I'll tell you.
Oh, you fucking dick.
We're back. We're in Goldfield. The little town of Goldfield.
Oh, they're building the Goldfield truck stop.
Ah.
Oh.
Another little town.
Showing all the mines up on the hill there.
And all the mines on the hill. It's a little gold mine town. Got a speed monitor. It's blinking because Tony's going over the speed limit. It's gonna say slow down. Build houses. And all these old trains.
Did you watch the vice presidential debate?
Old trucks.
I've watched it this morning.
It's a nice little town. It's good.
I can guarantee you one thing.
A little steam engine.
There's going to be a spoof that involves a fly. And if you take the debates and never watch it, you'll see what I'm talking
about. All these old buildings are made of brick. It's an old building. Courthouse.
Fire station.
The
general store.
Look at this
sand.
Cars and boats with all the bottles on them.
This big hotel on the left here, Wyatt Earp owned a saloon in it, they're saying, according to the history.
Tonopah Station. Little houses. And sign shop.
Main Street. Goldfield Visitor Center.
On the next town.
I see over there, I don't know if you can see it with my phone, but they rerouted the highway around because they found gold. Looking like over where that truck is. So they had the gold mining company paid for the reroute so they could get into the gold over here. I'm thinking it's over where all that equipment is. They're just stocking in there, but from what I understand, what I heard, that they found gold, so the gold company rerouted the highway around where they found it. So that's a pretty cool little history. Pretty nice little highway through here. Well, there's one for all you single guys. Like Barbara Bell. You guys don't know who Barbara Bell is anyway. So there's some more mines over there. So
we're in Tonopah. Little town of Tonopah.
Another gold town. Gold mining town. We're at 6,256 feet right here.
Tonopah Station. Food, hotel, casino.
Used to be a McDonald's here, but I guess they couldn't make it.
Speed limit's 25.
Not 35? Dang.
No.
Hey, there's a Beans and Brew restaurant.
Hey, look at that. Riley's.
Riley's. Oh, that's that grocery store we went to that one time.
Uh-huh.
That's Tonopah Station, the casino.
Another little town you blink and you're through it.
Yeah, we're gonna stop in a little bit. Get out to where. Yeah, there's a mining museum right here. The history of mining. It was pretty cool. I went there once. I had to come up here for work. And I went through that. Oh, don't go to the economy end if you want to party, because
it's tired.
They told me to never come back. All right, we're turning on the airport road.
That was it.
Oh, there's a little more out here. All the tailing piles from the old mines right there.
ready. We'll get you to the next town.
Alright everybody, we're back. We stopped for a bathroom break at this little turnout thing. Over there's the that's the Tonopah Airport over there. Down there, I don't know if you can see it or not, there's a car coming. There's some to the right of that brown thing there is the Tonopah Racetrack that we've been to a couple times. So this so far so good. Everything's riding pretty good. So, look at that's what happened to our tire. It blew it out pretty good. Anyway, I don't know. I don't remember what they call this valley, but Tonopah's on the other side of that hill, about 5 miles back. You go that way to Ely, Nevada, and we're going up north to Eureka. Hold on. Anyway, they have a lot of gates here, like this one here, because they have open range, a lot of open range. So their ranchers come through these gates and round up their cows. Hopefully we'll get to see some antelope on the way up, towards the, you see that light spot in the hill, I'll zoom in on that. There's a light colored hill up there, way over there. There's some mine, another big mine up there. And that's, we'll show you that when we get there. So, all right, that's part of Tonopah. And what are you doing, blonde lady?
Checking the tires, making a sandwich.
I already checked the tires. She made us some sandwiches. Yeah, everything's riding pretty good. So, all right, we'll get back to you in a little bit when we get to the next place. Okay, that, I remember right, that is the Tonopah Jail. I was reading Lost Treasures of Nevada. Supposedly a guy robbed a stagecoach of gold and buried it, and he buried it where he could see it from his jail cell. Kind of ironic, but if I remember right, that's the Tonopah Jail right there. Or anyway, the jail's up there somewhere. So anyway, that's a little legend that the guy robbed the stagecoach, and he, before he got caught, he buried it just somewhere around the Tonopah Jail, so he could see it from his jail cell, and nobody ever did find it. So, a little interesting Nevada history. So, all right, we'll get back to you in a little bit.
All right, I'm back on. Tony wants me to tape the terrain here. The whole lot of nothing, just flat. Some hills over there.
We're in smoke
place over there.
Smoky Valley.
We're in Smoky, coming out of Smoky Valley. We just got our tires, new tires, because we blew two tires, so had to get two new ones. I guess that's the RV life.
Got a pretty good deal on the tires. We got them for $90 each installed.
Yeah, they were really nice people too.
A little town called Carver, Nevada. So, you see that we got a big old terrain change. On the flats, there's not much for sage and all that stuff. And now we got trees up in the mountains, and the mountains are pretty steep. Over to the right, you see all that light color? That's ranch land. Big old ranches.
It's pretty cool, pretty good drive. Not much internet.
Ready, we're at Wally World. We're getting ready to head up to the mountains. Hi guys. Hi, what are you doing? We head up to the mountains. I'll show you some stuff on the way up. Alright. Good morning, everybody. It is Friday, October 9th, the day before the hunt. We spent the night in the Wally World parking lot. When was the last time you had a hot shower and a tent in the Wally World parking lot? So we're heading north. We got about an hour to go on our journey to where we're going to camp for the till we decide to leave. So we're heading out of Elko right now. Alright, thanks. We'll get back to you in a little while.
Alright guys, this is the long road to where we're going. Is this still Elko or is this...
No, we're on State Highway 225 in north of Wild Horse Reservoir. We're about an hour and a half from Idaho border.
All these roads that we've been on is like a nothing. Oh, there's a house there. Hey.
That's from the tractor guy.
Oh, we got a tractor crossing here. Oh, look at that barn. That's an old barn.
It's like, honey, the highway's coming through. Oh yeah, where are they going to put it? Right between the barn and the house.
Yeah, they divided that property right down the middle. Alrighty, we'll get back at
you. Little cafe up here that we ate at a couple years ago had some pretty good food. Little bar, and look at all them RVers, the hunters, hanging out there.
Yeah, we got a bar, so we come down and get a drink.
It's the Lone Mountain Station. Oh, restaurant and bar.
Yeah. Alright. It's a pretty little area.
Huge ranches up here too.
Alright. Tell them. There's a cow. Oh, there you go. Cow crossing.
Yeah, that picture's for Frank to give you an idea of what kind of cows are up here. You thought that goat was bad. Ready to meet some of the cows out here in the wild. All right, we'll get back to you.
Cattle ranch, pastures. See if we can see any deer in here.
We usually do. Big black deer.
Yeah.
Angus deer.
these, so they're probably all laying down. Out there.
That steak on the hoof.
Yeah. Nice little valley.
Tractor guy again. Yeah. The guy gets around it on that tractor. All the sheep.
Yeah, a bunch of sheep.
Yeah, they sold the grazing rights and the sheep come in and eat the grass down so you get a better crop next year.
I don't know if you could see that green. They got a one lamb that's painted green. That's the lead one. If they get that, one, all the rest follow it to hurdle places.
Like, hey, everybody's over there.
There's a group heading out.
They're going over to join the rest of the herd.
Well, there's a lot of them.
Yeah.
I hope we see that many deer this year. Well, if I saw a herd like that of deer, I'd faint. I could pick out whatever one I wanted. Holy cow.
Speaking of cows.
Nice little spread this guy's got. Got the cows. And there's the sheep herders in their little trailer. And that's the ranch. You got a big spread of land there. Wild horse. Looks like there's quite a few people here already. Got campers over here. Sorry about the sun glare. Got some campers already camped down in there. Wild horse ranch. Bunch of RVs over here, but parked.
Where's that? Little
conveyor. And here's the RV park, ice, food, beer.
And that little restaurant we ate at?
Yeah, they have good hamburgers. Good hamburgers.
Good hamburgers.
Hamburgers. Hamburgers. They have a little RV park there too.
You can see over on the other side of the house is the reservoir.
Yeah, that's the lake we're gonna be fishing on.
Little creek.
Little creek.
Oh, that's that creek thing that we
another were sign, deer crossing. There's usually deer down in here, but I don't know if there is today. An antelope. No. Oh.
another picture of it. What you doing, blonde lady?
Oh, the fun thing.
Dumps the poo-poo. Cleaning out our septic tank for so we can camp for a week. So, yeah, this is a wild horse reservoir state park. The dogs. They wanted to get out. So this is where we are. We come here, you pay $5 and you can dump your RV and fill your fresh water up. So that's what we're doing, and then we're gonna head to camp. So, all right, we'll get back to you in a little bit. Here we are, guys and gals. We're on the road to where we're gonna go camp. This is our hunting zone. They're one on the road, right side of the road is Area 71. The left side of the road is our hunting area. And we're going down here a couple of miles. And gonna turn left and go back in.
Big bump.
Place I found.
Cattle guard, lift your feet. All right, we'll get back to you when we find our spot.
All right, here we are. We're going back into the road where camp is. This is the countryside we're gonna be camping in. We got about a mile to go back in on this road. I found a spot on Onyx Maps. Leanne's got this thing all loosened up. I can't.
Big bump.
All right, trailer.
Yeah, I'm panicking. This is my house that we're towing back here.
The road's really not that bad.
No, but still.
I'll tell you, look at the white knuckles on that hand.
Hey, you know what? I watch the road.
So do I.
No, you don't. You watch everything else.
Yeah, but I'm doing all right, aren't I?
No. Oh, yes. Back here with our fifth wheel. I'm all nervous.
Give her the white knuckle express for Leanne.
Well, it's like this is our first time towing the fifth wheel. It's a little heavier than an Articap trailer, you know, and it's like my house.
What do you say? Mobile home.
It's my mobile house. And the road is kind of crappy.
We've been on worse.
road's crappy. Oh, easy. And my poor cat's back there riding. It's probably stuck to the ceiling by now. She's a trooper though, she's so rare. Back to you. Alright, this is the camp area Tony picked out.
It's a virtual goat trail.
Yeah, we'll see what's behind here.
Check this out, guys and gals. This is the view out of our pop-out window. And that's my view looking at Leanne.
I could live here forever. Look at the view.
Look at out the windows. I don't know if you can see it. There's a couple glares on that, but I'll get closer. Look at the views. That's the view out the back window.
Sorry, dirty. I have to wash it.
Leanne. Good bitching, we're camping. That's the view out the east side. That little thing right there is a creek, or a crick, or a stream. Depends on where you're from. I'm calling it a crick. And the dogs are been out playing in that water all day. They're wore out. They've been running and running and running. It's at the freedom. Here's the little window. Isn't that cool? This is the life. We're never leaving.
Yeah, really.
All right, guys, gals. Thanks for watching our channel. We will get back to you. Stay tuned for more. This is the first video I'm going to put out. God bless everybody. Support your troops, support your president, support your them.
How do you know you're not taping the back of
your head? I don't. How do I know what?
How do you know you're not taping the side of your face?
What? Okay. Thanks, guys and gals, for stopping by. Stay tuned for more videos. Support your troops, support your president, support your essential workers.
Get out.
What?
Get out and vote. Get out and. Vote.
All right, everybody, we'll see you on the next one. Stay tuned for more. We got like almost 30 days up here, so I'm gonna try to get a video out as often as I can. All right, God bless, guys. Catch you on the next one.